Alright guys, so in this video I'm going to show you how to wire the Fire Lite LCD-80F enunciator. I know it can be a little confusing if it's your first time because wiring this enunciator is different from the Fire Lite ANN80. So we have our 24 volts, okay, 24 volt non-resettable power right here, and the EIA-485 bus, okay? Now this bus right here is your communication for the enunciator. So if I can just, I'll just zoom in on it, move the camera, okay. So we have four wires, one is in, one is out. And so basically in and out, so out is going to the enunciator, in, this is coming back from the enunciator. So you can kind of think of it as a class A circuit, but it works a little different. So what I'm gonna show you is what's gonna happen if I don't have all four wires in the terminals. So, what I'm going to do is if I unscrew the out terminal, one of them, and I remove the one wire. All right, as you can see right here, it says LCD-80 supervisory. And you can hear the LCD-80 in the background. And you can't see it from here, but it says communication fault. So I'm going to acknowledge the LCD-80. Okay, so when it powers up, it still has power from the 24 volt non-resettable power, but it lost communication with the fire alarm control panel. So now I put the wire back in and the LCD-80 trouble will clear. Honeywell life safety, system all normal. Now I'm gonna show you what happens if I remove the in terminal. This is coming from the enunciator. So I'm gonna remove that wire right there. Okay, trouble in system. Once again, LCD-80 supervisory. However, the enunciator, I know you can't see it, but it's saying the exact same thing that this is saying. It's not saying communication fault. And the reason why is because it's still getting its communication. However, the return conductors going back to the panel are the ones that are affected. So if the enunciator says communication fault and you have an LCD-80 supervisory, you know it's your output wires. If you have both an LCD-80 supervisory trouble on both the enunciator and the panel, you know it's your input wires. So that's kind of the difference between the two. I figured I'd show you just so you understand. So I'm going to put that wire back in. All right, Honeywell life safety, system all normal. Now I'm going to show you how the enunciator gets wired. And I have Will with me here in the background. Yeah. So over here is the enunciator. All right, I took it out of the wall to show you. Right now it says communication fault. It has 24 volt power, but at the same time, it's not programmed into the system. So here's the back of it. There's your 24 volt power, okay, right there, positive and negative. And here are the communication lines. So they plug in. You can unplug them and plug them back in when you're wiring. So here's my in and my out. One is coming from the panel and one is going back to the panel. All right, I had to use three 16-2 wires to the enunciator. And if you can, you want it to be shielded cable. And to include Will in the video, Will, why don't you tell them why it has to be shielded cable?
If I'm not mistaken, the shielding for the cable has to do with protecting the wiring on the inside from interference from outside signals.
Yep, that's exactly why we have shielded cable, especially with the for the enunciators. However, mine's going literally, I don't know, 15 feet.
So it's not really. It particularly helps in buildings where you have a BVA system installed.
Yeah, but mine's a demo system and it's going like 15 feet, so I'm not really worried about that. All right, so our enunciator is wired correctly, okay? We have the correct wires on the correct terminals. Now we have to program it into the system.
You did the wiring. I'm not sure it's done correctly.
Yeah, very funny. All right. So now we, as you can see, it says communication fault. We're going to come to the panel, and it says system normal. It doesn't see the enunciator. So I'm going to press enter, 2 for programming, our default passcode, and I'm going to come down to 3 for option modules. All right, and it's going to say 1 for enunciators. Term enabled. So I'm going to enable this, okay? Yes. Now, if I come over here, You can see the enunciator is now online with the system. So anything that the panel reads on the LCD is going to happen here at the same time. Now you also want to make sure you have the correct dip switches on. So for you to have the piezo and for the to use the key to enable it, dip switch 2 and dip switch 3 are going to be in the on position. 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 are going to be off. Okay? So now we can escape. And we're going to go test the enunciator. Alright, so now it's time to test the enunciator. As you can see, the AC power LED is illuminated, and the LCD says the exact same thing as the main fire alarm control panel. So now what we're going to do is we're going to put our key in the enunciator, we're going to turn it, and we're going to press reset. So now we know that our enunciator works and is operating properly. Reset in system, and now the system is initializing. And once you're done, take your key out. If you guys have any questions at all, please feel free to ask. Hope this video helped. Talk to you soon.